if you are just starting with the desk, do you want me to show you some cool things that you can do with it?
Yes, that would be great.
Very cool. So first of all, the biggest thing is the SLA. So you will have different kind of clients, different kind of cases that you will need to have a good service level agreement. For example, let's assume that I am part of your 20% clients that are holding your company. And that's usually the case. You have some strong clients that you need to keep happy. They will be, for example, as part of my gold SLA. And then whenever tickets are coming from their organization, I know that in 2 hours, I need to respond to their tickets. And in 6 hours, for example, I need to resolve their tickets. And you can do it based on calendar hours or based on business hours. So if, for example, in 2 hours, no one responded to their ticket, then we can create some kind of an escalation that goes to a manager, reminding the agent. We can do lots of cool stuff here. But that's, I find, very, very important, especially when you're dealing with the high caliber clients that you don't want to lose. Any questions about the SLA?
No, that's good.
Okay. You can work on the notification. In the notification, you can see which people will get notification and in what which cases. For example, when you have a new contact notification, you can send an email when a new ticket is being created in the system. And that's only for the contact. You can have exactly the same setting also for the agents and also for teams and departments. And while you turn on and off, the automation will take place or not. Now, you can also go to the pencil and you can change the notification itself. So if you want to write different wording or you like to include more data, you can also do it from here. In the agent section, you can see all the agents in the company. And in the permission, you can set which permissions you like to give to each one of those agents. So every agent will be assigned to a role, and the role is really what he can see. It's not about what he can do. It's only about permission to data sharing. And from the other side, you have the profile, and the profile will tell you what the person can do. The default system coming with that agents can, for example, delete tickets. I don't think that anyone in the system except the administrator can delete anything. So I would always take off the delete option from all those places. I saw too many bad things in my life. Mm-hmm. So I don't want to give anyone delete permission.
Okay.
Also, if you look here, the agent by default getting tons of permissions. Probably they don't need access to half of the things that they already been given. And you can just, for example, turn off some of those features and then they won't be able to access those features. If you need to import information from previous system, you do it using the importability on the left side. There is tons of automation that can take place using the workflow and assignment rules. The assignment rules will be more for when a ticket comes from a specific client, assign it to the person who is in charge of this specific client. And then the person that is working on the client is getting those tickets immediately without having someone in the middle that's supposed to distribute the tickets to the right places. The workflows also is very, very cool. You can have lots of cool stuff. You can close, let's say in my case, I have in my system, in my desk system, lots of rules that if I'm getting notifications, let's say meeting updated, invitations, all those, I don't need them in desk because I already getting all those notifications to my calendar. So automatically I'm closing tickets based on the status. So as an example, close tickets. If I can type tickets, okay, and we'll go to next. And here I can say, for example, when a ticket is created, only then I like to execute this rule.
Okay.
And then here you can see that you have different criterias. I will select if the subject contains invited. So if there is invited, then usually it will be columns and then the name of the meeting. So it's if it's invited and columns, then I am going to initiate a field update and I will just close this ticket. The status will be closed. Okay, so once I will get a ticket and the ticket will say invited, it will automatically be closed. And I have lots and lots of rules like that because I don't want to have so many tickets that, you know, just wasting my time on closing them because I know that they need to be closed anyway.
Got it. Looks good.
Okay.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you.
And I think one last thing that is also important. You have a way to create different departments. Try to have one department if possible, because when you're creating multiple departments, there is a problem to work between departments. Every department will have its own workflows, own assignment rules. So once you have multiple departments, the maintenance becoming extremely difficult. So it's cool to have different departments. Also, creating lots of work in the maintenance.
So if you had one department, then how would you split up those different workflows for them? Is there a way to do that? If there's different, I mean, one department would be, they'd have to have their own work groups, I guess, right?
It depends. Sometimes you cannot avoid having multiple departments. And that makes sense when the department is completely different. Let's say sales and support.
Right.
Or implementations. So it's totally different people and everything is different. When you have the same people in that's doing different things, but it's the same people, sometimes, you know, you're better off having one department. It's just, I'm not saying don't do it. I'm just saying do it only if you have to.
Okay.
Because it will create lots of work in the maintenance. So it needs to have, you need to have some kind of planning before you determine which departments you're going to create.
Okay.
Okay?
All right.
Do you know how to change fields in a ticket?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. No problem. So here you can see the layouts and fields.
Yes.
Under customization. And if you will go to the layout, you can see that on the right side, you will have different kind of fields.
Oh.
And on the left side, you will have the existing fields. You can just drag and drop, let's say, number of employees. So I can just drag and drop, and I can name it number of employees. And now when I will save this view, you can see that I have the number of employees as part of my ticket.
Okay.
Now, same like Zoho CRM, you can have your different type of, you can have different type of information. You can have layout rules and display different fields for different criterias or based on pick list selections.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the desk can also integrate with CRM and pull information about accounts and contacts. It's a very, very nice system.
Oh, it can pull the contacts, because one of our issues was with the contact, we were having problems trying to link the ticket. One of them came over with a different name, but we recognized the contact person and it came up as a duplicate. So we weren't sure how to merge that or title it, you know, without creating another duplicate contact.
Yeah, so need to check it out. There is a chance that the data was uploaded to the CRM and desk and then it was merged. It's just something we need to see exactly. Okay. What's the cause of the problem? For sure, there is a problem if you're starting to have lots of duplicates.
Yeah. Well, we just say there was a duplicate, so it wouldn't let us change it. It wouldn't let us add it to a contact. I guess it already existed another way. So I was curious to how to link it, I guess, to an existing contact. Or maybe merge it. I guess after seeing that today, you could do that in Desk. Merge it, merge that specific contact to another contact.
So many reasons for it.
Yeah,
It's something that we need to see. But in general, something is going on, and you will need to check it out.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
No problem.